Opportunities don't happen, you create them. With this quotation, I, Shivani, welcome you all to Sense Independence. So let's begin with today's top BuzzFeed.
Supreme Court dismisses plea by EX-BSF Jawan Tej Bahadur Yadav. SC dismisses plea by EX-BSF Jawan Tej Bahadur Yadav against rejection of his nomination from Varanasi. Supreme Court has dismissed the petition filed by former BSF Jawan Tej Bahadur Yadav against the dismissal of his nomination from Varanasi Lok Sabha constituency. The court said, "We have done what we could have done. We find no grounds to entertain this petition." Rahul Gandhi's citizenship can't be questioned, says Supreme Court. In a relief for Congress President Rahul Gandhi, the Supreme Court on Thursday dismissed a petition seeking to direct Election Commission to debar him from contesting the Lok Sabha election for voluntarily acquiring British nationality. The apex court quoted saying, "We cannot rely on a paper note to call Rahul a British national," dismissing the plea over Rahul's citizenship. Rajiv Gandhi lost his life due to hatred, said Ahmed Patel. A day after Prime Minister Narendra Modi called former Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi Bhrashtachari number one, senior Congress leader Ahmed Patel hit out at Prime Minister Narendra Modi and the BJP for targeting Rajiv Gandhi during election campaign, saying it was the Saffron Party that was responsible for the former PM's assassination. Workers burnt alive in fire at a sari shop in Pune. In Maharashtra, there was a big accident in Pune on Thursday. At least four people died due to suffocation in a fire at a famous sari shop. The incident happened late last night. At that time, some of the staff were sleeping in the above room of the store. Dead body of ASI found at a deserted place in Bihar. In the Sivan district of Bihar, the unfortunate criminals brutally murdered an assistant sub-inspector of the police. The slayer carried out the incident in a deserted place where the body of the deceased was recovered after getting the information. Police are investigating the case. The royal family announces the royal baby's name. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry went with a non-conventional name for their first child. Aki, the 37-year-old Meghan Markle, conceived an offspring on Monday, May 6, to their kid, and she and her better half, 34, appeared him to the world and to Queen Elizabeth on Wednesday, after which they uncovered the child's name, Aki Harrison Mountbatten Windsor. WhatsApp decides to stop supporting Microsoft Windows Phone. WhatsApp has reported that it won't provide services for the Windows Phone from December 31, 2019. WhatsApp's announcement is in accordance with Microsoft's choice to end for the help of Windows 10 mobile gadgets in December. Austin Jones behind the bars for 10 years. Austin Jones urged six underage young ladies to send him explicitly expressed recordings in private messages, disclosing to some they expected to demonstrate that they were his greatest fan. After being brought in front of the court, he has been sentenced a prison sentence of 10 years. Reports reveal the actual life of Michael Jackson's kid. Michael Jackson's most established child, Michael Joseph Prince Jackson Jr., isn't the normal trust fund kid. In spite of the fact that his dad left $30 million, neither of his kids displays his riches via web-based networking media. Repolling in 13 polling stations in Tamil Nadu on 19th May. The Election Commission of India Wednesday announced conducting repolling in 13 polling stations in Tamil Nadu, where the Lok Sabha elections were held on 18th April. The decision came after errors during polling were reported in 46 booths across 13 districts in the state. The EC has asked the CO to inform political parties and candidates about the repolling and give wide publicity in the areas.
That's all from today's top headlines. Subscribe and press the bell icon to get the latest update. Stay in touch with us to stay in touch with the world. And don't forget to follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.